Hello all! KMK here, come with another Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle video. And this time, I'm going to do something else. And that is, I'm going to discuss something that I really want to talk about. Like, for a really long time, and that is, let's talk about Extreme Z Awakenings. Most importantly, I'm going to talk about Extreme Z Awakenings of units that have the chance to become extremely powerful. Like, unbelievably powerful. And I'm not talking about these guys, like, for example, I'm not talking about the Super Saiyan God, Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken Goku. I'm not talking about him. I'm also not talking about Vegito, or Super Vegito, I mean, there's Vegito, or Vegito Blue. I'm not talking about those. I'm talking about units that you can pull in any banner. Like, not Dokkanfest exclusives or anything. Units that you can pull in any banner. No matter what, you can pull them. Either you pull them on a legendary banner or you pull them on a Dokkanfest banner. These are units that can be pulled on any banner in the game. Like, I'm talking about units like Caligula or Bojack, those kinds of units. But in this case, I'm going to talk about units that have the chance to become extremely powerful, like the greatest of all time units. Units that are forgotten. Units that most of you guys most likely don't even remember exist. And I'm going to talk about how great these units are going to become once they get their Extreme Z Awakenings. So, and you guys might ask, well, KMK, what type of units are we going to talk about then? Yeah? Well, let's just say, here's a good example. These are units that I think represent everything that I want to talk about. Look at this Vegeta. He was really mediocre, not so great, till he got his Extreme Z Awakening, and then he became like this godly monster. Like, it's not even normal. He that he hits both of the 1 million and everything. And he has like this really weak key multiplier and such. And yet he hits extremely hard. Units like this. Like, they went from barbershop food to holy shit, oh my fucking god, I need to rainbow this guy and I need 5 dupes of him. Now! Those kinds of things. And units like Trunks, who went from something like this to something like this. Like, these guys, and he's a support unit, by the way. Literally a support unit, same key multiplier, but he hits hard. Like, so hard. And those are the units that I'm going to talk about. Nothing else. And nothing more. So, by all will and means, I will use these guys as an example of how I think that they should be awakened. To be Extreme Z awakened. And I will not talk about any of the units in a particular order, like from worst to best, but I will just mention them and I will say why. But now all is said and done, let's go and talk about Extreme Z Awakenings. And the first one that we are going to talk about is the physical Super Saiyan Bardock, which is an OG unit, and really an OG unit. And it used to be so extremely good. Like, this guy, when he came out, he was one of the units that was used a lot because of his passive and because he gives 2 key. He was used in tournaments. I used him even in tournaments, and well, I will be honest, he was awesome. Like, he's beautiful. He's like a great unit, really. But, and then he get his awakening into this Bardock. A bit of an well, maybe back in those days he was a bit he was good for if you don't have anything now, but nowadays he's mostly forgotten, and he was like really good unit. And he can still seal attacks and such. He gives 2 key and plus 20 attack to all allies when HP is 30% or above. He has also some really nice categories and some common links, including Saiyan Pride, which, believe it or not, is pretty good. And the First Awakened, which also is pretty good. But that is it. He doesn't add anything else. He doesn't he's not as great as he used to be. And the thing is, when he see awakens, he's going to be really good, like monstrously good. I could, let's just say you got for example, where is he for the Goku family. Look, you got this pen here. And this is her. This is her passive such. And Bardock says the same one, but with key. But 10 attack less. But when he awakens, he will replace her on the Goku family team. And I could easily see him getting an ECA like this Trunks, that he went from something like this to something like this. And this Bardock can become that, like, easy. I could easily see him become a support unit for Pure Saiyans or for the Goku family. Most likely the Goku family, because it would be such a good passive for him that he is surrounded. Maybe if they add an Team Bardock category later, he could even get a passive for that, which I hope he will get a Team Bardock. Would be so good for him. But he would be a monster, because he has everything. And if he get that Extreme Z Awakening, he Super Battle Road, he would be great. He would be good in the Legendary Goku event. He would bring a completely new level to the Goku family team, to any of these categories that he would be in then. But most likely Goku family, if they go the same route as they went with Trunks here, or the Vegeta. But maybe not. And he has so many good links, which, I will be honest, he is a unit that deserves that awakening, especially since how great he was in the beginning and when he came out. And that's something that I really want. I want him to become this really great unit, awesome ECA unit, everything. And that is my hope for him, because he has such amazing stats also, like almost 10,000 defense, and then that 13,000 attack. It's so insane. So insane unit. When these stats are being put up to the extreme. So this is a unit that will become really good when he gets his ECA. And maybe even give him something like what Super Vegeta has against, but then against the Wicked Clan in the Universe category. So when there is a Frieza or so, he will do an 100% crit chance, guaranteed crit. So really an amazing unit. On to the next one. Another Bardock. The only Super Saiyan 2 Bardock in the entire game. And again, a unit that deserves an ECA. But first, going into the history. This Bardock was like, when he came out, he was like the Super Gogeta of his generation. Like, literally the Super Gogeta. He was that amazing. He everyone was pulling crazy for him, and he was, and the drop rates were really bad back then, really bad. I did not play at the time, but I heard stories, I seen videos. It was insane, and this guy was really wanted, and he had extreme damage and such. It's such a weird thing to see that a unit like this, who was like the king of the game, and later it became replaced, and now he's kind of forgotten also, and it's also kind of sad. And they made him at the end like the only Super Saiyan 2 Bardock in the entire game. And well, let me say a few things. One, we need more Super Saiyan 2 Bardocks. Like, really, it's about time that we gonna get another Super Saiyan 2 Bardock. It's really needed. Secondly, when this guy ECAs, I'm not gonna talk about the ECA yet, but he can already get a lot of attack. Like, I had it a few times that I got like over 800,000 attack with this guy. He had over 800,000 attack, and he was still hitting really hard when he creates and such. See, even though he has, this is his multiplier, and but he buffs his attack so by 50%, so that makes up for it for a bit. But still, it doesn't make up for the fact that he, he also has this lead skill, but we're not going to talk about it further. Well, the thing is, he's also getting really forgotten. And when he ECAs, he has an extreme amount of potentials. Like, what should I say? If he ECAs, he would be a must-have on the Vegeta family team, like on this team for Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta. If he ECAs right now, you want this guy on Vegeta's team, because yeah, your team will be extremely strength heavy, because you want to have Super Saiyan 4 Goku also. But the thing is, when Bardock ECAs, he will make this Vegeta a monster. Because Vegeta gets strength hero type units 120%, which is not so bad at all. But the fact that this Bardock has like Daar is het Shining Pride, 15% attack. Well, it's great for this Vegeta. Link this Vegeta up with Super Saiyan 4 Goku, and then with our good friend Super Saiyan 2 Bardock. Vegeta will hit like a truck. He will hit maybe harder than Goku here. Like, it's not even normal. Really a great unit, and I would also, I can easily see him becoming just like this Trunks. Same type of passive. Maybe a little bit different. Oh. And of course I made a boo-boo. Let me pull Bardock. And he would easily become a great unit, really. Especially with this passive, because they will most likely improve this. I can guarantee that this will be improved. It will most likely become 9 turns. Getting so 70% attack. Like what this Trunks says and so. Maybe like Vegeta can also be. All in all, again, a great unit. Also, he's on a lot of category. Resurrected Warriors, he can link up with Legendary Broly, the Tech one and the STR one. Same here in Pure Saiyans. Awesome, Goku family. Well, I use him in the Goku family. You guys have seen it. Awesome unit, really. Awesome unit. Really a unit that I recommend. So if you pull this guy a few times, trust me, when he ECAs, you will be happy that you kept him. Like, seriously. Well, up to the next one. And you guys already seen him. And the next one is Hellfighter 17. Of course you guys are going to say, but KMK, why Hellfighter 17? Don't we have AGL 17? Then I will have to say, why the hell would I pick Android 17? Well, we already have an extremely good Android 17. We already have like MVP 17. We already got in. We don't need another 17. I mean, you can give AGL Android 17 an ECA, but it's the use. You won't be able to use him on the Android target, except if you only got Android 21. But why would you use Android 21 when you got 17? MVP 17 is already a really good unit. So, no, I picked Hellfighter 17. And secondly, the only way that I would say that let me say it like this. This 17 will become really good. I can honestly say that. But the problem is, we already got an Android 17. I see no point in using him. That's the only thing. Even though he will become amazing. Thing is, we already have a good 17. The only reason that I would say use this guy is when Bandai or Akatsuki or Dokkan changes his name to Android 17 GT. If this guy was named Android 17 GT, put him in, then I would have said yes, this guy, but I did not. So, nope, I went for this guy. Because he can be put on the Android category team easily. Like, done, he's in. That being said, How does EZA look like? Well, simple. Look at Vegeta. Vegeta is basically the same as... Spoiler, that was a spoiler. Forget that you saw that. Anyway, this Android 17, Hellfighter 17, is the same as this Vegeta here. Same type of passive. As you can see, completely the same. And there is no denying it. But, here's a but. I can easily see him getting the same type of EZA as this Vegeta. Like, easily. And it would actually make him really, really, really good. Like, immensely good. Because there is no, well, you get a cell, but there are better cells, so it is what it is. But I could easily see him getting the EZA of Vegeta. He has the same he has a better attack, of course, so it will he will get, of course, defense and such. And most likely this will become better. Stunning in Super Battle Road is great. That they can remove. Not really needed. It would really make him a lot less useful. Even though he has already Shocking Speed, he has GT and such. But still, he could use it. And I think he will most likely be just as Vegeta is for the Vegeta family category. I could easily see this this Hellfighter 17 being in the androids and artificial life form, and maybe later in the Super 17 arc. I mean, do these guys need key? I don't really know, but I think they could. He would really work here. He would be a good buff for this team. Also, I could easily see. Yeah, he would be a good buff for this team, and he would be amazing on this team. Like, the Android team would be so broken with him once he gets his EZA. Like, that's how good he will become. Especially when he is already paired up with units like this Android 17 and 16 and so. Especially when, but that will all be after Super 17 gets his EZA, but that's a year away. Anyway, again, a unit that will have an awesome ECA, and it will become, he will become really amazing, like really one of the top tier units for his category. Anyway, the next unit which I accidentally spoiled, Super Saiyan 2 Goku, the Whirlwind Strike. Now we are with him. This unit, long time ago, won the voting. There was a time that you could vote for 7 units that would get a rebirth, so to say. And this Goku was the winner, when he was this. He won the votes, and they later made him like this. They even gave him immense damage, which was a lot, especially for a time that that a unit that get an awakening got immense. So that was a big shocker, especially for a support unit. But now he is more or less forgotten, which is kind of a shame, to be honest. Especially, yeah, how wanted he was in those days and how great it is. I mean, plus 3 key is a lot. And he was used in the tech team. Yeah, in tech. Back in those days, he was in Super Tech, and then they added him in. Now, first they added him in Normal Tech with Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks, but we all know that Gotenks doesn't want that, but still. Later, he was used in Super Tech with Goku. Again, Gotenks didn't like it, but that's Troll Tanks, but now he's more or less forgotten, he is unwanted, and if someone pulls him, they are like, oh, I did not know he existed. That is the type of guy. He's the type of, it's the type of unit that if you pull him, you will be like, oh, who is that? And then you see him and you will be like, oh, that's Goku, the Super Saiyan 2 Goku that won the vote, or for some of the art, or for the new players, this Baba Food. And this guy really could use an EZA. Like, for one reason, he has immense damage. If he gets an EZA, he will be insane. Just for the fact that he has immense damage, and he's a support unit. He would be like one of the best support units in the game. But I would not say in the game, that is a bit exaggerated from my part, but I would say he would be a great support unit for his categories. Because, look, Majin Buu Saga. He is a part of the Majin Buu Saga team, and this team is in dire need of help. At the moment, the only good support they got is the LR Great Saiyan Man 1 and 2. Nice and dandy and so. And anything else. But I would say, if they give this guy an ECA, like, change this completely, complete new ECA. I would not say which one of the twos. I would say make it a combination of the two. Of Trunks and Vegeta, but make this a more damage oriented support unit, and change this to Majin Buu Saga. Majin Buu Saga, and I think he would be a really good solid unit for that category, because Majin Buu Saga is at the moment one of the worst. I think I could easily say one of the worst. And it needs all the help it could get. I think more support units for that category alone would be really wanted. Like, he's just one of those units that really needs it. He is totally forgotten. He has this great legacy behind him, being voted by the fans, of course, and such. And just in general, being one of the first rebirths that got immense damage, which was unheard of at the time. So I would say this guy definitely needs an Extreme Z Awakening. And when he gets it, everyone wants to pull him. I can honestly say that this guy is... This guy is greatness in the making. This, you guys don't understand how good he's going to become. He is really, really a monster that is still sleeping. That is a sleeping beast. And once that beast wake up, it will be great. It will be legendary. So that is all I can say about this Goku. The next one that should get an ECA is, of course, Pandel. Why Pandel? Well, Pandel is like a really good unit. It's here from the Dragon Ball Fusions. Back in the days, he was one of those exclusive banner Dragon Ball Fusions, and well, she was really great. She She gave this to everyone, and she was one of the best units to have on a fusion team. And nowadays, she's still being used. But that's the thing. She is, how to say it? She is not up to date. She doesn't get defense, she doesn't get attack increase or such. She is there to buff the other fusion characters, but when she gets hit hard. She gets like, how should I say, when she gets hit, it's literally face down, ass up, a pounding of a lifetime. That is what she's getting. Once she's getting hit, if she gets hit in the Legendary Goku event or in Super Battle Road, she is a unit that actually needs the laugh. And she could easily get Trunks awakening. His awakening would really help her. Like, it's the only thing that I can think of that would work, because well, she's in Fusion, she's in Hybrid Saiyan, she's in Puppy Girls, and these are all great categories, and I would say keep it like this, but give her, yeah, this. Just give her this. This is what she needs. And that would be the only thing that she could use, and maybe also give her that. If they can give her something like this when she ECAs, she would be already pretty damn good. She is. That is how great she is. And that is all I will say. She has, for her doing, she has good links. She has Fused Fighter. She has Shattering the Limits. There are a lot of units for Shattering the Limit, especially in the Puppy Girls. She has Battlefield Diva. She has GT or so. And Fighter is, I don't know. But oh, good unit. Would love to see her getting an ECA. Next one is the sexiest fusion in the game. Bullpen. And the reason that I say this is, she was, again, when she came out, she was already extremely good. She was like one of the most used units that came out of the Fusions banner, at the Dragon Ball Fusions banner. She was used in Super ATL, and that was in that time pretty damn good. We had Super Vegito and such, and all in all, it was a great unit to begin with. I never pulled her, I pulled her later on. I rainbowed her on the Vegeta banner, just in case you guys ask. I haven't tried her yet. I do want to try her, but the thing is, yeah, her passive is a bit outdated. But she has beautiful art. It is basically, this is Bula if she was more like Vegeta. Let's keep it like that. But this passive is so outdated right now. It doesn't do a thing. Like, literally, it does nothing anymore. Yeah, the plus 3 key is nice and such, but we all know what we need. We want plus 30% attack, or plus 30% attack and defense, and those kind of things. And C is in the same category as this Goku. She is a sleeping monster, and that's all I can say. She is a beast that is sleeping. A sleeping beast. With a lot of potential. She has like, of the fusion banner characters, she has a lot of potential. Like, immensely powerful potential. Again, she is in a lot of good categories, even in the youth, which to be honest. I don't think that you'd need it. Or maybe it does, I don't really know. I don't. Here's the thing, I don't use the Steam often. I like the Kid Goku, but I never put much time in making team. But I think she, if she gets an ECA, she would boost that team. Hybrid Saiyans would really benefit from the boost. Especially with her key, because, well, let's face it. Ultimate Gohan doesn't have any good key links, so he only has shocking speed, and she could basically fix it for him that he can work that way. She would be good in fusions, but if Pandel gets an ECA, Pandel would be the better unit for the fusion category, but she would be the better unit for the hybrid Saiyans. And maybe Peppy Girls. She is. I hope she will become more of a damage dealer, technically. But on the other hand, I would say whatever it is, she is going to be great. Up to the next one. Ah, go on. My boy. The Vanguard Warrior's True Value. This go on was like also a really good unit at the time. He was a sport unit, but he was not that great, let's be honest. He was not that great to begin with. He gets attack, but that's all. It's he was there, but he was not really. There were units that did his job better. Later, he got his ECA, but technically, he got shafted. Let's be honest. He came out the same time as the Strength Ultimate Gohan for the Hybrid Saiyans, and they shafted him. He should have gotten Fierce Battle. Let's be honest. This guy deserves Fierce Battle. I'm not gonna lie. He deserved Fierce Battle. This man was treated unjustly. That being said, why should he get an ECA? Well, and is he worth the ECA? And now, well, here comes the thing. If he ECAs, oh, he will be a boost to a lot of categories like Hybrid Saiyans, because he's the best link partner of Ultimate Gohan. Majin Buu Saga. That category needs a lot of key support. And if they give him 40% and make it so that he gives key to Majin Buu Saga, oh my god. This guy would be an insta rainbow for everyone. Everyone will be like, I need this Gohan for my Majin Buu Saga team. And he would literally rock the dragon. Like, oh, he has shocking speed, he has Kamehameha, Super Saiyan, Sea Fighters, Golden Warrior. I think most of these links are in the Majin Buu Saga. Including Shattering the Limit, but if he gives himself key, plus two key, well, he will be awesome, because nothing can compete with him then. Especially if they give him the same ECI as Trunks here. Give him the same ECI as Trunks and he would be extremely beastly. Like, really, really beastly. Because he's in the Goku family, he is in Siblings Bond, and I think that's, yeah, Siblings Bond can use a good support unit. No, they already have Vegeta and Trunks. I think. Do they have Trunks? Oh, they They don't have trunks. Huh. Yeah, then he would be really good. Together with Vegeta and such. Really, really good unit. Especially with the LR Gohan and Goten. I don't have those units, I don't like them. I find them shit, but other people like them, so I don't, but I do hope for people that have them and with so uninteresting unit that has that needs time to build up for ski. I hope that they give this unit an ECA, this go on, so that the sibling bronze team with these guys, that they will have the extra spot that they deserve. Let me say it like this. If this guy is good and maybe I would say I would wait till the GoPros will come back and I will pull them and maybe I would use them, but at the moment too much hassle. But if this guy would get an ECA, I would even give my red coins for the GoPros then. But that's just me. But mostly I think Majin Buu Saga needs it when it happens. So definitely this guy, don't sleep on him. He will be great when he gets an ECA. Like monstrous. Next unit. Golden Mallet's Golden Freezer. The best linking partner for Golden Freezer Angel. Like, what can I say about this guy? He is like, he was the first Golden Freezer ever in the game. And he is in the same predicament as the incel. And sorry people, that was my ventilator. I moved a bit in a certain way and now it is blowing in. So I'm gonna apologize for that. But the Golden Freezer is in the same predicament as this cell here was. Because before this cell got an Extreme Sea Awakening, this was his passive. Like, and as you guys can see, same type of deal here. Basically, they are each other's, they are like brothers. Let me say it like this. They are like, well, I got the same passive as you, but only 20% more as such. And this cell became later an awesome unit and beast. He got greatly raised his attack. He got 90% attack defense. He is a monster in Super Battle Road. I'm still shocked with him. When I was doing the resurrected warriors category, he tanked everything. He was tanking so hard, and he kept increasing his attack, and he kept healing. He's a great unit. All in all, a really, really good unit. And he has a lot of categories and such, but to get back further to Frieza. So, as you can see, this is how great that this guy became. But of course, we are talking about Frieza here. Does Frieza need it? Well, he does. Not only being the best linking partner, he needs a new lead skill. And I think, because this is Frieza. Frieza is known for being really durable. I hope that they change this into increasing defense. Every time he supers, he becomes tankier. Tankier and tankier and tankier. This, of course, needs to be changed. I don't know in what way they can change anything else on him. But if they give him like 100% attack or 110% attack, he would be a really good unit. Like, really. really good ETA unit, especially since he is on some, well, these are his names, but I'm talking about categories. He's in movie posters, full power, transformation boost, wicked bloodline, resurrected warriors. I think he would be a nice buff to Golden Frieza, Angel. Of course, I could have talked about this guy. Let's see, where is he? I could have talked about this Golden Frieza, but yeah, there's not much to talk about because this alone here, this part here, makes him win it already. But I want to be different. I'm gonna go talk about the lesser one in that regard, and that is this Frieza, and not about the best tank. And this Frieza has also a lot of potential. He could be extremely good, and I would say also don't sleep on him. He has a lot of potential. He might be even better later on the Legendary Goku event, because of the fact that his defense will increase non-stop if they give him defense increase. Make him the opposite of Cell. Instead of attack, he gets greatly raises defense. And maybe also a passive like what Cell has, whatsoever. And I think this is, or better yet, give him the same type of passive as it is Broly. He could benefit from it also. Give him the type of passive that Broly has. If they give a passive like this to Frieza, it would also be good. This guy is like an open book. He is like, he has so much options and potential. And he could be so great on certain teams also. Resurrected warriors, movie bosses, full power. And that's what I want to say. He is really, I think he's one of those units that is being slept on. And I hope he gets an ECA really worthy of him, of being the first Golden Frieza in the entire game. And I would really love to see it. Anyway, and here's the third one. And now we go to what I think personally would be the two best ECAs in the entire game. Like, the next two units will be so great that I have to say it. They will be so great. So here we go. Are you guys ready? The unit that I'm going to talk about was most likely going to be a beast, going to be a monster, like, oh, and that is the Masked Saiyan. And some people have talked about him. They slipped. They were talking about him. That oh my god, maybe he should get an ECA and such. And this guy should. Like, today I was using him. And a few times before that, and I still am amazed. And this is also why I was making this video. It's all because of this guy. This guy made me like, I should talk about the units that people forgot, or that people don't know exist anymore. And that's Bardock. Masked Saiyan. It's Bardock, but you guys know what I meant. And of course you guys are going to say, but he's a Dokkan Fist unit. No, he has a Dokkan Fist style awakening. Yes, he has a Dokkan Fist defend. But he is not a Dokkan Fist unit. He is in every banner. He is in every LR banner. He is in every Dokkan Fist banner. He is everywhere. Like literally. He's even standing behind you, looking over you, I should watch this video. That's how he is everywhere. He's even when you're in the toilet and you're taking a shit or you're taking a pee, he is there watching you. Because he's everywhere. That being said, why are you saying, of course, you guys will be saying, KMK, why is this guy going to be so great? Why are you so hyped about him? Why do you say he is an unbelievable monster? Why would we believe you? Tell me, convince me, KMK, convince me, why is this guy such a monster when he gets an ECA? And I'm gonna say simple, I was using him today, again, and he was on a double 120% lead, because I was farming medals for this guy. I was farming medals for him and for the AGL Super Saiyan Goku. Anyway, and I saw his attack. This guy, when he super attacks, had over 941,000 attack when he was supering, which is a lot, especially with such a raw attack boost like this. And I'm gonna say that's how hard he hits. He hit it even harder than this Goku, a Dokkan Fest exclusive. He hit it 1040 more than this Goku. I'm a bit exaggerating. Well, he hits harder than this. He hits close to the 1 million. This Goku doesn't even hit close to the 1 million. And that is only because Bardock was on a double 120 lead. This guy would hit harder on a double 170 lead. It's like the Goku family, but I'm not gonna go into that nerd shit. Anyway, what does that mean? That if this guy got an ECA, because, well, first let me go back into the history. This guy was like the Gogeta of his time. Like, he could have villains and he could have heroes on his team. Simple as that is it. 50%, he was like the neutral type of Super Saiyan Rose and Vegeta Blue. That also came out at the time. I think after or before. But I don't know when. Which one came first, chicken or the egg? I bet someone in the comment section will say it to me. Anyway. That being said, when this guy alone, he already is close to 1 million, he would literally, if he ECAs, he would literally be in the top with all of the good Dokkanfest exclusive units, like, that's how good he will be. He would like, I would say he would be in the top 10. Top 10 units of Dokkan. Of the TURs, Dokkanfest exclusive units. Because even if this guy got an ECA, if he got an ECA, this guy would still hit harder than him. This guy would still hit harder when he gets an ECA. And this, that's how good the Mass Saiyan is. The Mass Saiyan will hit harder than this guy without question. And he would literally be in the top. That's how good he would be. He would be among the best units in the game. And the best thing is, he's in every banner. And they just have to give him a better leader skill. They have to give him better percentage-based attack and defense. They need to remove this. This needs to be removed. Maybe change it a bit so that he gets more attack. They can change this guy. Let me say it like this. If they ECA him, they could make him a weaker version of this Broly. A weaker version of this LR. Because that's the potential that this guy have. If they ECA him, they could easily give him something like this, what this Broly has. Something like... that's an example, eh? Not exactly, but more as an... He's a lesser version of him then. Because when the Master Saiyan got out and we got later Super Saiyan 3 Broly, he was Super Saiyan 3 Broly's best linking partner. He still is one of the best linking partners for Broly. Because of Berserker, Prepared for Battle, Fierce Battle, the Saiyan Lineage, Saiyan Warrior Race. That's how good he is. He is also on a lot of good categories. He's on the Pure Saiyans. Which, if he was on that team, he's broken. Like, he would. If I have put him on a double 140 team, he would literally. No, 140, 150 team. He would literally be close to the 1 million. Or even above the 1 million. That's how great he is already now. At this moment. That's how hard he hits. He's basically on the edge of being in these, in the Token Fest exclusive power. And if he gets an ECA, he would be broken. He would be among the elites. I think he would be like, would he be like Gogeta? Let's see. Would he be like Gogeta then? No, he would not be like Gogeta. Not yet, but his stats would be close to it, I think. Nah, he wouldn't be close. That is a bit of an exaggeration for myself. But I think he would be close to some of these ECA units. I think. And that is why I say he has the... He is a titan. A colossus. A monster. Waiting to be awakened. Once that ECA comes, do not sleep on him. Keep the dupes of him. Rainbow him. Anything. But once he awakens, and the beast is unleashed, I swear to you guys, this guy is then the best unit that you can get out of any banner. That's how great he will be. And I dare to say he will be. He will be better than the Broly. He will... A yellow Broly, of course. And he will be in the top... he will be in the top with all those token first, with the greatest token first exclusive units in the game. Not with LRs, but just the normal ones that go to TUR. That's how great he is. Anyway, let's go to the last unit. And that unit is Drumbeat. It's Vegito. Base form Vegito. Yeah. It's base form Vegito. Of course you guys are gonna say, why him? Why base form Vegito? Isn't Bardock? Yes. Bardock is great, but like I said, It's in the units that are named are not in any particular order. They are just in what I think would be extremely good units when it's the ECA. And this Vegito is going to be a beast. Like, he was already good. He was like Vine. I'm going to say it right now. He was like Vine. The more units that came out that were better and better, the better he became. He was ripening like wine. And he still is. He is like one of those units that has a lot, and I mean a lot of potential. And he is so good. Like, there is no joke about it. He has awesome links, and he has 30% for allies in attack defense. He gets 25% attack. This guy has the whole shebang. Like, literally. And he was already good before he even had his awakening. Because this was his awakening. This was how he was before. And this was on his release. He was like such a good unit. He had this leader skill that was really good. This leader skill was really good before the key became popular. And nowadays, he's still good, but he's starting to struggle. He needs some extra love. And this guy, if they give him this ECA, and I mean, if he gets this ECA, yeah, because he doesn't need to have an exact ECA like this, because he will most likely have more than Trunks. Most likely. It's just, also he will be a big boost on two really powerful, on one really powerful category, and on one really weak category. On a weak category, he is like the strongest boost that you can have, like the Mighty Boost Saga. Like, if he is, if that Vegito becomes a 40% support unit, well, this team is fixed. It's healed. It's awesome. It's like, yay! They fixed him. He is finally, they fixed this category. Bang. That's it. But then you got this team, Botara, and category that I don't like. It's a kind of boring category for me. But if he gets his ECA, then he will be there together with Zamasu and Gowasu. Like, they will be together there. Because they will be together there on that spot. Gowasu will be more there for the 70% defense and such, but when he will also give 40% attack, and this category already has so many good units. Like, it's insane, and they will become even better. This Vegeta will become a monster. Because this will be after he gets his ECA, yeah? Just so that everyone understands. This guy will become a monster. And C will become a monster. He becomes he becomes Satan. That's beyond the monster. So he will become Satan, the Satan of Dokkan. That's how great he will become. This guy will all these units will become so immensely powerful. Like, and then I have to talk about with Of course, the new leader that is coming in the future. There will be a new leader that will have a better leader skill than these guys here. These guys will be changed for something better. And this guy would would be so great. Like, really, he would be insane. He will buff a really weak category, and he would buff an extremely powerful category, and he is like, wow. And it's insane. Like, I have no words for it. It's like, I'm just, everything that I'm just saying about how great he will be, it's going through my head so much, and I'm like, I don't know what to say anymore. So that's how great he will become. I have no words for it. This guy is like, this guy, these two are sleeping monsters. They are like, when these guys get their awakening, they will do a lot of damage. They will do so much greatness for their categories. They will become immensely good. They will never become forgotten anymore. This guy and this guy will be good till the end of all eternity. They will be insane. It's so, and what can I say, it's such a miracle that with ECAs, units like these will have the chance that they deserve. They will, and these, all of these units will shine greatly, like immensely. They will become more than what they used to be. They're gonna break the limit. And that's what I want to see. I want to see these guys become great. And a lot of these guys, there are a lot of units that are also favorites of mine. This Vegito, I love this guy a lot. He did a lot for me when I was in the beginning. When I was doing the World Tournament, I didn't even have him, but he did so much for me with his passive. He used to buff my Broly and such, and Broly was banging everything down that there was. This guy was great. He really buffed my Super Saiyan 3 Broly. He was a godsend. He was like, I'm there to help you, boss, and I'm so happy about it. This Frieza, it's, if I switch him out for my Bojack and such, when I am using Bojack, then I switch him out for the Tech Golden Frieza. When I take Bojack out, I put him in. He's one of those units that I really would like to see ECA. This Gohan needs an ECA. He is damn good. She needs it because her legacy, she was a great unit at the time, and she needs to come back to it. She is already great, but she could use a little bit more because of the new legendary Goku, and she could use the help in Super Battle Road. This guy, he's a legend. He deserved the ECA. He needs it. This guy deserved it because it's about time that he gets the love that he deserves. He needs to be seen as a great unit. It's time that he shines, and it's time that he gets some praise. I don't use him, but I would use him once he gets in the ECA and he becomes like Vegeta. I would really, really like to see this guy get the praise that he deserved then. His time in the spotlight. This guy needs his comeback. He's long overdoing a comeback. And we need more Super Saiyan 2 Bardock. So he's the only Super Saiyan 2 Bardock. He needs it. And we need more Super Saiyan 2 Bardocks. This guy, he needs to come back. Like, really, he needs to come back. But most of all, these guys are the ones that will shine the most. That's my opinion. Share me what you guys think about it. Do you guys agree with me, or are you guys disagreeing with me? And yeah, let me know, eh? There was KMK saying adios, auf Wiedersehen, sayonara, arrivederci, and auf Wiedersehen, and see you all next time. KMK out. Bye.